explanation of the fiqh of Hajj. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant all of us Hajjan Mabroora.
Ameen.
And we reach the most important pillar from the pillars of Hajj. It's the most important one. What is the most important pillar of Hajj? Huh? Niyya? No, pillar. Ruk. Huh? Arafat. Yes. Okay. The fourth pillar standing al-wukuf at Arafat. Standing at Arafat is the fourth pillar of the pillars of al-Hajj. This is due to the Prophet's statement sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, al-Hajju Arafat. Hadith sahih. Means al-Hajj is Arafat. What does it mean al-Hajju Arafat? Hajj is Arafat. Can you explain more? Huh? Yes, importance. What else? Yes. No, it means no Hajj
without
Arafah. That's why they would bring the day of Arafat, the sick people, in the ambulances, because they are coming. You know, some people, they book for Hajj. Where is Indonesian? Raise up your hand. Indonesian. How many years in Indonesia to go for Hajj? Maybe 15, 20, 25, depends. So after you go, after all these years, you are going to Hajj and then you become very sick. You are in the hospital. Night of Arafah. So what they do? They take all the Hajjaj in the ambulance and they take them to Arafah. Just 5 minutes is enough. Their Hajj will be valid. But if they didn't go, No Hajj. Very important. Hajj is the most important pillar. And if you missed Arafah, no Hajj for you. In actually, it is to be present at the place that is called Arafat for a moment or more with the intention of standing there during its valid time. What is the valid time? From the
Maghrib.
Which day first?
9th
of? Day of Arafah, right? Day 9 of Shahr Dhul Hijjah. Okay. From when? From Zohar until?
Maghrib.
Okay. From Zohar to Maghrib.
From sunrise.
Huh? No one is saying there is no other time? Only until Maghrib?
Until
Fajr. Until Fajr of day 10. Until Fajr of day Eid. Eid al-Adha. If someone went to Arafah at night, then he went to Muzdalifah, his Hajj is sahih, valid, correct. Okay? In the past, when it was time is full of barakah and ease and everything was subhanallah al-azim. I know some righteous people in Mecca, the citizens of Mecca. They told me just 20, 30 years ago, they would fast day of Arafat until Maghrib and take their iftar breakfast in their house. Then take their Land Cruiser, their car, and take the intention of Hajj, put on their ihram, and go to Arafah. Then go to Muzdalifah. It was very easy. Just take your car and go. Just 20, 30 years ago. Now, Allah musta'an. Even if you are living on the borders of Arafah, you cannot enter Arafah without permission. Allah musta'an. So, Sheikh here is saying the valid time from Zuhr, midday, on the 9th of Dhul Hijjah to Fajr of the 10th of Dhul Hijjah. Standing at Arafat has obligations, recommended acts, sunan, and manners that make it complete. They are as follows. The obligatory acts, wajibat of Arafah. Number one, being present at Arafat on the 9th of Dhul-Hijjah after high noon until sunset. 2. Spending the night at Muzdalifah after coming down from Arafat on the 10th night of Dhul-Hijjah, the night of 9th in English terms, like after Maghrib. 3. Okay, before Jamarat, I just want to say that combining between morning and night, daytime and nighttime in Arafat is wajib, is compulsory for many scholars. But if you didn't do your Hajj, maybe you will need to slaughter a sheep or something, but it's valid. It's valid. If someone left Arafat before Maghrib, actually, Saudi Arabia, they do something very nice. They close the borders. No one can go out. They put the police cars.
Barrier.
Yes. No one can go out before sunset. They are keen that your Hajj will be valid. Once Maghrib starts, no adhan. You will not hear the adhan.
Yeah.
Even if you are in the masjid, Masjid Namira. No. Masjid Namira in Arafat, the huge masjid. If you are inside and Maghrib time, first time I went there, it was maybe my first Hajj. Then I'm making dua and waiting until the adhan. No adhan. Mobile is making adhan 5 minutes. No adhan. I said, why no one muadhan? I said, because no one prays here. Everyone Muzdalifah. So you will not hear the adhan. No adhan in Arafah for Maghrib. Everyone moves quickly to Muzdalifah after sunset. If you are with good company, you will reach before Aisha. If you are with, you will reach before Fajr. Allahumma sta'an. So, we should not leave Arafat before Maghrib. Number 3, Rami al-Jamarat, throwing pebbles at the stone pillar of Al-Aqaba on the day of Nahr.
So when they will pray Maghrib?
Yeah, they pray Maghrib. The sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he reached Muzdalifah, he reached just before Isha. He prayed Maghrib, then they put down their stuff from the camels, then they prayed Isha. This is exactly what he did, alayhi salatu wasalam. He did jam and qasr. 3 rak'ah and 2 for Isha. So once you reach Muzdalifah, the sunnah is to make salah quickly.
As soon as possible.
If you reach before Isha, no problem. Maghrib and Isha, you make it earlier. If you reach after Isha, no problem. Maghrib and Isha, you make it jam' ta'khir. No problem.
Both correct,
no problem. Then, sunnah in Muzdalifah is to
sleep.
Just with your sleeping bag, pray watr one rak'ah,
yes,
and sleep. This is the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
Sheikh, nowadays you are going by walk, and after 5 minutes you are.
Yeah, because you're very tired in the dua of Arafah. So mostly you can sleep.
Extremely tired.
Yeah, extremely tired. Then sunnah is to sleep. So here is saying it's compulsory to throw the jamarat, the stones.
Seven stone
on the day of Eid. On the day of Eid. So the starting time of throwing stones when? Who can answer this difficult question?
What?
When can we start to throw the stones?
After Zuhal.
After?
Zuhal.
No, for the first day. No, yeah, this is correct for day 11, 12, 13. Hmm. I speak about Rami
al-Aqaba.
Huh?
After Fajr.
Morning.
Yes, after Fajr, this many scholars, almost Jumhur, they say that you cannot throw at night unless you have permission or you have rukhsa, if you have women, sick people, old people, then you can leave Muzdalifah after midnight. If you left Muzdalifah after midnight, you can go to
Jamarat
and throw the stones. Okay? And some scholars said, no. You can leave, but you cannot throw the Jamarat unless Fajr is starting. Same rule for going to Haram. If you leave Muzdalifah after midnight, some people go to Haram directly to make tawaf, al-ifada wa sa'i. So it's very empty, very easy. If you go tawaf after midnight, no one, all Hujjaj go after 7 o'clock.
This is only my first day.
First day. Yeah, I'm speaking about first day. Very empty. But some scholars said that Tawaf al-Ifada is invalid before Fajr of day 10. You have to wait until Fajr. Okay, so two opinions for the scholars. Of course, Sheikh bin Baz bin Uthaymeen and others, the scholars of Saudi, they say it's allowed. So alhamdulillah, if you are taking with this opinion, after midnight, you have two options. Usually in a group, we have women. So we have permission that all of us will leave. So the bus can go to Jamarat to throw seven stones, or the bus can go to Mecca, to Haram, to make Tawaf al-Ifada and Sa'i. Okay? Number four, Al-Halq, shaving or shortening the hair after stoning the pillar of Al-Aqaba on the day of Nahr. We shave, of course, after that. Five, spending the...
Some say before, after the Biyam, then you can make...
No, it is doing two out of three. Two out of three. Tawaf al-Ifada, Rami al-Jamarat, Sa'd, and also we have five things on day of Eid, right? Five things. What are the five things? That's why it's called Al-Hajj al-Akbar, Yawm al-Hajj al-Akbar. What are the five acts we do on day 10? Al-Hajj. طواف الإفاضة
الساعة
رمي الجمرات حلق الهدي هدي okay five things so by two things out of three you can make تحلل رمي الجمرات طواف خلاص you can shave then it's simple and this is the things that Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم when the Sahaba came and one said Ya Rasulullah I did this before that افعل ولا حرج you can do and no problem Ya Rasulullah I did this before that افعل ولا حرج you can do it and no problem the Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم gave us very high tolerance flexibility to do anything before anything on the day of Eid for these five acts
even سعي بفوت عف
No, no, no. Sa'i should be after Sa'i because this is based on this.
No.
No, yeah, any. You can make. Yes.
Yes.
Number five, spending the night at Mina for three nights, which are night of 11, 12, and 13. It means, in the English term, day 10 after Maghrib, day 11 after Maghrib, and day 12 after Maghrib. And these three nights are compulsory to stay where?
Mina.
Mina, yes.
Even short time.
Even short time.
Where you go for 1 hour and then you can become your hotel.
Even short time.
Yeah.
The best is to spend most of the money. This is the best. But even if you spend short time.
Also valid.
Also valid. What is more important, Arafah or Mina?
Arafah,
of course. If you stay 5 minutes in Arafah, your Hajj is valid. If you stay in Mina, even some scholars say staying in Mina is just sunnah, yes. But of course, if you have good company and you have your tent in Mina, don't leave it. Why you leave it? Unless you want to sleep in the hotel, then you can stay from Maghrib until mashallah midnight and then go, for example. And some people, they do Jamarat at night. Jamarat is from Mina. I know that maybe some brothers, they don't understand what we are saying. Because Hajj, to imagine Hajj, it needs that you go to this place and understand, otherwise a bit confusing. The fiqh of Hajj, we need to do it on site. May Allah take all of us to Hajj next year. After why, inshallah? Going? Yeah, who is ready, inshallah? We make a list. Inshallah, inshallah. Okay. Number six, throwing the stone at the Rami al-Jamarat, day 11 and day 12. Day 13 is sunnah.
Day 11 after Zuhr.
After Zuhr, starting. But no limit for the end. You can until Fajr. But starting time, Zuhr. Because Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was waiting until the Zuhr time starts, then he goes to through and then come back for Salah. It means that he is waiting for this starting time. Okay? So it's better not to throw before Zuhr and then after, if you want to avoid the heat and the very hot weather, you can go at night, no problem.
This rule is also day 12 and day 13.
Yes.
After Zohar.
Yes, yes. All Jamarat after Zohar, except the first day.
First day.
From midnight. Okay. From midnight or Fajr, two opinions. Yeah. So this is the obligatory acts. Walhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. Newcomers, welcome. Newcomers. Where are they?